The game opens with this really awful, devastating explosion. It knocks down 6 square blocks of Empire City.
Hurts and kills, you know, thousands of people.
But somehow you survive. You have these crazy electrical powers. One of the things that we really find fun about superhero stories is the process of understanding where these powers came from and why they're there. In Infamous, this isn't a question that gets answered all for you at the beginning of the game.
The phrase that we always talked about was zero to hero. You want to be this guy who's incredibly low status at the beginning of the game, and you want to be either famous or infamous at the end. You become this superhuman person. Do you use that for good or for evil?
The sorts of decisions you make like that, minute to minute, affect how the whole city reacts to you.
There's a lot of depth in the behaviors of both the enemies and also the non-player characters, just the citizens.
I've been robbed!
The sort of systemic complexity of the game is something that allows the player to have unexpected, exciting things happen.
Feds dropped some more medical supplies, but they landed on that roof. Could you knock them down?
There's this enormous world of side missions and quests that you can do in Infamous, which is on the order of 3 times as many things as the primary path has.
You're not in just one big long tunnel going from the beginning of the mission to the end of the mission every time. You're in a city and you can go wherever you want, whenever you want.
The cutscenes really were an attempt to tell stories that feel genuine in a graphic novel sense. They don't feel like we're exploiting the genre. They feel more like we're part of that genre. Really beautiful, detailed graphic art, but all kind of taken into a dimension where it can be animated and rendered and using effects to kind of tell our stories, at the same time really having it feel fresh and something people hadn't seen a lot of.
At first, it's just the standard disaster film where you happen to have superpowers. And as you get more into it, you understand that everything is not as it seems, and that the people you know aren't necessarily who you think they are.
It's like peeling an onion. You figure out one thing, you think you understand it, and then you find out that, well, you kind of understood it, but there's something deeper going on.
We've hidden all kinds of little narrative hiccups, which I'm sure people are never going to see. The casual player is never going to understand the depth of everything going on in Empire City. However, if you're a really dedicated player, if you're somebody that really wants to know every last bit of what's happening, it's there for you. You just have to decide that you want to explore this huge 3-dimensional sculpture that is Empire City. And you can just go right down the rabbit hole.
You're asking a critical thing of our players and our viewers, which is to believe that someone could get electrically superpowered. And that's kind of the gateway to the whole game.
Electricity is great because it's kind of malleable in what you can do with it. I mean, you can do the obvious, which is shoot somebody in the face with a lightning bolt, which is, I know, for me, kind of a core fantasy.
He starts out with 2 or 3 superpowers he can do, and throughout the game, we unlock more and more of them.
He starts off with the ability to throw electricity from his hands, and he has the ability to throw out electromagnetic pulse waves.
It's an electric wave that's traveling out in front of him. Everything from that to the really crazy stuff you might expect with lightning, which is calling down a massive thunderstrike. They're more conventional things like grenades and rockets, but we've framed them in a way that it is Cole using and extending his powers.
Over the course of the game, you end up getting another 15 or 16 powers. And those powers, in addition to the ones you start off with, are all upgradable, at least 3 ways. And most of them actually end up having good and bad upgrades you can do depending on how you're playing the game. If you multiply it all out, I think you got over 80 powers that you end up with.
Cole is very dependent on electricity, and while it's the source of his strength, there are also a lot of weaknesses associated with that.
I'm so totally grateful. You're a lifesaver.
One of his powers is that he can kind of resuscitate people who are injured, or on the other hand, he can drain the electricity from people in the game and use that to fuel his own superpowers. Anytime that there's an interesting resource that the character wants that inherently hurts someone else, you're faced with this choice of, I want this thing, am I willing to hurt this person to get it?
So in a lot of ways, he's kind of challenged by this gift. This is a game that delivers on something I've thought about all the time, which is, if I had superpowers, what would I do with them? You know, if I could turn invisible, would I go on a stealth mission for the FBI, or would I sneak into the girls' locker room? You know, these are the kind of challenges that would be presented to you as a real-life person when given superpowers.
We really wanted to kind of take you through that journey that you read about in graphic novels and you see on superhero movies. We wanted you to play that. Remarkable, these guys have created between 20 and 30 minutes of animated movies in a remarkably short period of time. Clearly there's voiceover talent that's contributing to this, and there's music and scoring that's going to happen after it, but the principal production of that at Sucker Punch has been four guys really almost by themselves for, you know, a little over a year, and it's been a remarkable achievement for those guys. We'll be right back.